Dear viewers, I hope you are all fine. This ultrasound video shows multiple findings, including pleural effusion, thick-walled gallbladder, multiple renal stones, ascites, and calcification in the uterus. The patient is a female patient aged about 80 years. You can see the liver and pleural effusion is seen. Pleural effusion, sometimes referred to as water on the lungs, is built up of excess fluid between the layers of the pleura outside the lungs. The pleura are thin membranes that line the lungs and the inside of the chest cavity and act to lubricate and facilitate breathing. Common causes of pleural effusion include congestive heart failure, kidney failure, pulmonary embolism, trauma, or infections. Patients with pleural effusion may experience sharp pain in the chest, shortness of breath, and coughing. Symptoms of pleural effusion tend to subside when the underlying condition is treated. You can see the thick-walled gallbladder. The gallbladder wall measures more than 6 mm. And a small amount of thick sludge is also seen in the gallbladder. Diffuse thickening of the gallbladder wall can occur in a number of situations: cholecystitis, acute cholecystitis, chronic cholecystitis, and gallbladder empyema. It may be caused by repeated attacks of acute cholecystitis. Chronic cholecystitis may cause intermittent mild abdominal pain and no symptoms at all. Or no symptoms at all. Damage to the walls of the gallbladder leads to a thickened, scarred gallbladder. Ultimately, gallbladder can shrink and lose its ability to store and release bile. Now, the other causes include acute hepatitis, severe pyelonephritis. Systemic diseases that may cause diffuse wall thickness include heart and renal failure, liver dysfunction, portal venous hypertension, and sepsis. Now you are going to see the left kidney, and it shows mild to moderate hydronephrosis. This is spleen, and multiple stones are seen. Two large stones seen at pelvic-ureteric junction, and due to this, there is moderate to severe hydronephrosis. These are the stones. Cortical thickness is decreased. These stones are large. You can see the measurement. The largest stone measures about 19.1 millimeter. And the other stone measures about 9.4 millimeter. Now, next you will see the ascitic fluid. Ascitic fluid was also seen in the upper abdominal cavity as well as in the lower abdominal cavity. Ascites is seen as anechoic space on ultrasound. Ascites is seen as low density collection surrounding the bowel in CT scan. Bowel loop float anteriorly. Ascites is seen earliest in the pelvis due to its dependent position in the rectovesical or vaginovesical pouch. Traditionally, computed CT scan has been regarded as imaging modality of choice to demonstrate ascites. You can see the fluid in the lower abdominal cavity. This is the uterus and this is cervix. And you can see this is the ascitic fluid in the lower abdominal cavity. And ascitic fluid is earliest seen in the pelvis due to its dependent position. Traditionally, CT scan has been regarded as imaging modality of choice to demonstrate ascites and diagnose the underlying cause. However, ultrasound can reliably detect small volumes of fluid and is useful first-line imaging modality of clinical triage. Next, now you are going to see the age-related calcification in the uterus. You can follow up the patient for this calcification, but as the patient is 80 years old, this is age-related calcification, and usually it has no clinical significance, but and if you suspect any, you can follow up the patient with repeated ultrasound. Thanks for watching. Please, you can find some important information in the description of this video. Thanks for watching. Please subscribe my channel.